All architectural structures are unique works tailored to their specific locations and environmental influences. But how can we apply these principles in a completely different and challenging environment like Mars? Hello everyone, welcome to another exciting episode on the architectural journey. Mars, the red planet, presents a whole new set of challenges and opportunities for architectural design. With its unique environmental conditions and harsh landscape, creating a sustainable and functional habitat on Mars requires innovative approaches and cutting-edge technology. The planet's extreme temperatures, high radiation levels, low atmospheric pressure, and dust storms are just a few of the factors that must be considered. Elon Musk and his team are working on incredible projects to transport people to the Red Planet. They plan to travel to Mars with massive rockets called Starship, aiming to establish a self-sustaining city there. From farming on Mars to energy production and even building underground shelters, they're considering everything. If these plans come to fruition, it will mark a new chapter in human history. SpaceX's vision is truly exciting, isn't it? Speaking of building on Mars, NASA has also been exploring innovative ways to make this vision a reality. They hosted a 3D printer competition where participants designed sustainable habitats for Mars. These groundbreaking designs could play a crucial role in establishing a human presence on Mars, combining cutting-edge technology with bold architectural concepts.
This window, we have less than 30 seconds to place it. It is down to the wire. I could not have scripted this better.
All right, let's check out some of the coolest designs from the competition. Zopherus. Imagine looking out the hatch window and seeing this beauty tracking just perfectly. Welcome to the Zopherus habitat, a marvel of bio-inspired modular design that's easily expandable for future needs. Team Zopherus was awarded first place with its modular habitat for humans on Mars. 3D printed without human interference with materials made from the Martian surface. In this concept, the lander would survey its surroundings to identify the optimal print area, deploying autonomous robots from the vessel to collect materials for the 3D printer. Alright, picture this. During the material harvesting phase, these rovers are out there scooping up Martian aggregate, ice, and minerals. They then test and process these materials to whip up concrete from Martian carbonates and water. Once that's ready, the lander jumps into action, kicking off the printing phase with HDPE, a super recyclable thermoplastic. The lander's printer also has robotic arms to place prefabricated parts throughout the process. When astronauts need more living space, this printer is just a click away and ready to prepare a new module. The habitat's shell is like a bicycle tire and tube. You've got this thick, strong outer concrete layer that's protecting the thin, flexible inner layer of HDPE. It's like having a tough outer armor with a comfy, airtight interior. The Zopherus habitat is undoubtedly pioneering a fresh approach to space exploration and human dwelling. Marsha. This picture you're seeing isn't actually from Mars, but the reality of our dreams becoming true might be closer than we think. This photo was taken right here on Earth. Team AI, Space Factory from New York, snagged second place in Phase 3, Level 1 of the competition. Marsha is designed as a vertical cylinder, and there's a good reason for this. This shape isn't just efficient, it's optimal for creating a pressure vessel that can maintain an Earth-like atmosphere. The vertical cylinder design avoids the issues of domes, like unusable overhead volume and perimeter floor space. By going vertical, Marsha effectively reduces structural loading and maximizes the living area. One of the coolest features of Marsha is its double shell system. The outer shell handles the pressurization and thermal insulation, while the inner shell is light, airy, and optimized for living. This design not only makes the structure more resilient, but also creates a beautiful, light-filled space thanks to a large, water-filled skylight and well-placed windows. The design incorporates integrated ducting for efficient airflow and climate control, ensuring a comfortable atmosphere on each level. For construction, AI Space Factory is using a special 3D printable material, basalt fiber-reinforced polylactic acid. This thermoplastic is not only strong and recyclable, but also renewable. By combining PLA with locally sourced basalt fiber, the material becomes an excellent insulator, crucial for dealing with Mars' extreme temperatures. At ground level, there is a wet lab for external systems and research. Just above, there's a joint dry lab and kitchen, the main hub of the habitat. Moving up, you'll find individual cabins, a sanitation pod, and a hydroponic garden on the third level. And at the top, the bright sky room offers space for recreation and exercise, with windows providing a stunning 360-degree view of the Martian. Hassell. Imagine protecting astronauts from radiation using a thick 3D-printed shell made from Martian regolith. Cool, right? To tackle tension issues, lightweight inflatable pods are being brought in. These structures, made from high-precision, engineered composites, will save the day with their ellipsoid geometry, making spatial planning a breeze. Now let's talk strategy. They are rolling out a two-phase plan. Phase one involves a squad of 3D printing robots setting up camp months before any human explorer arrives. They're like the advance guard, constructing a protective shield using a modular robotic swarm strategy. Think of it as building your own fortress before moving in. Genius. These robots aren't your average machines. They're smart cookies with interchangeable roles. From scouting the best regolith spots to printing the habitat layer by layer, they've got it all covered. Plus, they can adapt on the fly, ensuring success even in the toughest conditions. But wait, there's more. The second phase begins. Once the astronauts arrive with all their gear, these robots switch gears to become flexible mobile platforms. Picture them rolling out like a convoy across the Martian surface, setting up the base with precision and speed. It's like watching a sci-fi movie come to life. Each living space unit is designed like a small oasis with everything astronauts need to thrive. From high-tech labs to hydroponic greenhouses and even virtual reality platforms, it's a home away from home. And the best part? It's all powered by cutting-edge technology, including nuclear kilo-power reactors and solar farms. In the end, a Martian base isn't just a place to stay, it's a sanctuary for exploration and discovery. Mars X House V1. Located in the northern hemisphere at Erebus Montes, this habitat is designed to face north, protecting it from the harsh solar radiation. It's got a super thick outer shell made of Martian regolith, up to 1 meter thick, which minimizes radiation exposure while still letting in light from the north. This setup ensures the interiors are bright and safe. So, how does it work? The habitat has two main layers. The outer shell is the regolith layer we talked about, which acts like a natural radiation shield. Inside, we have two inflatable volumes that form the living spaces. These are made from lightweight, durable materials shipped from Earth and inflated on Mars. They maintain internal pressure and provide comfortable living conditions. The openings are angled at 30 degrees from the horizon, allowing natural light to flood in. This light passes through a glass chamber filled with carbon dioxide, which further filters it, making it safe for the inhabitants. Imagine it like a snail shell. The top part of the structure is thinner, reducing the load on the habitat. Brilliant, right? Before any humans even set foot on Mars, a squad of 3D printing robots heads over. These bots scout the best construction sites and build the regolith shield. Now, let's take a tour of the inside. The habitat is split into three main sections. Level 1. This level is all about relaxation and enjoying the view. Here, you'll find the sleeping quarters and a stunning greenhouse that offers breathtaking views of the Martian landscape. Level 2. Time to get to work. This level houses the laboratories and a kitchen area. It's where astronauts will conduct experiments and prepare their meals. Level 3. Gotta stay fit. The top level features an exercise room, ensuring astronauts can stay healthy and active during their mission. Mars X House V2. First up, The Hercules vehicle, a single-stage reusable beast, makes a flawless landing on the Martian surface. This thing autonomously sets up the surface site, revealing an incredible hyperboloid structure. This structure is a stunning hyperboloid shape. On Mars, there's no atmosphere, so there's a lot of internal pressure pushing outward. To balance this pressure, they've created a surface just like a dam structure. The fibers wrapping the structure are designed to support continuous load due to the hyperboloid shape. Let's get a bit technical. The concrete structure is made from Martian regolith, reinforced with basalt fibers. The fibers wrapping the structure are designed to support continuous load due to the hyperboloid shape. The concrete structure is made from Martian regolith, reinforced with basalt fibers. The walls feature 30-degree breaks that allow natural light to enter while shielding from radioactive sunlight. Laboratories are located at the bottom, while living areas are positioned at the top. And here's the coolest part. The structure has slide-like arms wrapping around it for emergencies. In a pinch, these slides allow for quick evacuation. Finally, let's look at how well this structure holds up under Martian conditions. Plus, there are small windows allowing natural light to filter in. Mars Ice House. Research shows that Mars has enough ice to cover the planet up to 35 meters deep. Based on this incredible concept, we have the Mars Ice House project. The interior is wrapped in a polymer called ETFE, and just outside of that, we have walls of ice in two separate layers. This creates a buffer zone between the living areas and the harsh Martian surface. The transparency of both the ETFE material and the ice allows natural light to flood into the living spaces, offering a comfortable environment for the crew. Plus, it's brilliant how just a 5 centimeter thick shell of water ice acts as an effective radiation shield, reducing harmful ultraviolet solar and galactic gamma rays to safe levels. Beyond the buffer zone, there's a vertical greenhouse surrounding the living area. In this animation, you can see autonomous robots extracting the ice from underground and constructing the dual layer walls. Plants start growing in vertical greenhouses before the crew arrives. Isn't that impressive? Kahn and Yates. This project, created in collaboration with Kahn and Yates, reminds you of the Mars Ice House works, doesn't it? Unlike that project, water ice is not used as a building material. The structure is designed like a curved egg to minimize dust storms. So, here's the deal. This adventure kicks off with a space module landing on Mars. Once it touches down, a 5-axis printing arm extends from the core, using materials from the Martian surface to print the foundation and ground layers. Next, the printer arm starts building a concrete shell and the upper floor slabs. The shell has these perforated parts, and the structure thins out at the top, letting light stream in. The entire surface is then covered with HDPE layers. One of the best features is this elongated projection on the shell, allowing tons of daylight to flood in. This creates a bright, airy space perfect for gardening and food production. Chukablur. Introducing the Mars Incubator, a cutting-edge habitat designed for living on the Red Planet. This innovative structure is divided into 4 functional zones, each tailored to specific needs. The first volume is a vestibule area for entry and surface distribution. The second and main volume contains laboratory space, crew facilities, and life support systems. The third volume is a flexible space for multiple activities, and the fourth volume is a dedicated biogeneration space for plant growing. The manufacturing process begins with external support structures created by laser melting and fusion deposition of basalt fiber. It then continues with the placement of the lower panels of the exterior of the habitat, followed by the placement of the upper panels. These panels are made of regolith and polyethylene and are reinforced with impact-resistant fibers. The properties of these materials provide effective pressure retention and protection against impacts and radiation. So, are you ready to move to Mars?